Hey, have you got?
Yeah. I'm still pretty new to this, so I'm a little bit nervous with public speaking and stuff, so. Some people give it advice and they say, you know, you have to picture the audience naked. Sorry, Dec, look straight at you then. Gotta go on down there as well as up there, Dec.
That's
one of the mantras I've tried to use when I've been public speaking in all the jobs that I've had in the time. Which is probably why I'm not an English teacher anymore. I was a teacher actually. Yeah. Didn't last very long. Probably doesn't make jokes like that. Remember when I was coming to the end of being a teacher, I had like an appraisal, had to go and see the head of the year and like the deputy head of the whole school. And he held one of these meetings to talk about my performance, to review. And he held one on Red Nose Day. So I got caught up and I was a couple of minutes late. And I got told I was unprofessional for being late. Which I thought was a bit rich because they were dressed as Peppa Pig and Captain Jack Sparrow. I mean, in hindsight, they shouldn't have been dressed as Ball Ferris. Now I've gained a little bit more confidence in the past couple of years because I've lost some weight. What are you laughing at? Now in the past couple of years I've lost like 13 stone. Yeah. I've got a long way to go, but this time 3 years ago I was two steak bakes away from being one of them Channel 5 documentaries. But if you Google it right, 13 stone is the equivalent of 64,000 tea bags. Oh, Keanu Reeves. But I love them Channel 5 documentaries. It's either extreme medical conditions or celebrities making bellends of themselves. So like a typical Thursday night could be the man with the ball sack on his chin. Followed by Noel Edmonds goes dogging. Maybe Mr. Bobby. No, but as I say, I'm nearly at my target now as well, which is the Jackmo model. This is page 64 of the Spring Summer collection. Well, being a bigger guy as well, I've tried to grow a little bit of a beard. I've not much more going on, but I've tried to grow a little bit of a beard to find the hide multitude of chins. English student like that one with English student. Playing with it, didn't it? No, but from clean shaven, I look like a 12-year-old girl with a thyroid problem. She's sorry. Despite all this, I'm married. I thought it was an achievement as well. No, but I find that marriage comes with a lot of responsibility, I think, give and take. And I love my wife, I love her very much, but I don't get carried away with it. You know, I like to keep it in perspective. Keep on our toes. But I use Bruno Mars songs as a barometer. So, while I feel it's important that I buy her flowers and hold her hand, what the fuck catch her an A for it? No, but I find with marriage comes a lot of responsibility, you know, you have to worry about nectar points or what energy supply you with. You know, when I was growing up, there was nothing to worry about. The thing I worried about most was what trainings I loved at my mum's cage catalogue. I remember I got my first Reebok pumps. Anyone remember Reebok pumps? Yeah. Do you know what the pumps are? No? It's actually an internal inflation mechanism that provides cushioning to the ankle. Which is sound if you're of an athletic persuasion, but when you're a little fat fucker running around the streets, when your mates, it's not really much use for them. Hang on a minute, lads. Bit of a steep incline here. Think I need some cushion into the ankle. Alright, come on, we can go on. I can saddle this rough terrain. No, but as I say, with manager field comes a lot of compromise, a lot of give and take. So I like my wife likes films. She persuaded me actually to watch a favourite film the other week. You know, seen The Notebook?
Yeah.
So I said, well, so what's it about? And she said, I won't tell you anything about it to spoil it, but you're going to need the tissues for it. Best wang ever. Got throughout the audience for that. No, but she watched some shite on the telly, my wife. About ITV3 theme cheers. Anyone watch ITV3? Yeah? Murder, She Wrote in Colombo. Anyone see Murder, She Wrote? Proper glory and bitch, that Jessica Fletcher, isn't she? Surely Ross up when someone gets popped. Yeah, it doesn't get out of bed for anything else. You'll never see her do a drunken disorder, She Wrote. Or a bagel, She Wrote. Glory and bitch. I don't know why I don't like her so much. She just thinks she's on the telly all the time. But I'd like to see them do a remake for 2019. She wouldn't have a typewriter no more. She'd be on a laptop, wouldn't she? Is that fucking arrogant that she's one of them who doesn't press safely remove hardware before taking the USB out? And she'd be tweeting from the crime scene as well, wouldn't she? Just rocked up and solved this murder in like an hour. LOL. Hashtag fuck the police. Fucking slag. Oh, thank you for being amazing. I'll be on you, right? Thank you very much. Have a great night. Good night.